see the slow motion here. The bike swings down. Jens Fielder tries to take control. The Spaniards come over the top. Here we come down the back straight. Joby Dacus has been sitting on. Remember, these guys have been doing 40 miles an hour. Joby Dacus is in full control. Straight down to the black line. The quickest way. Lula Candriano thinks, yes, all that training I've been doing. Two or three times a week in the gym, doing those sprint efforts, focusing, diet, got it all right.
And you know, this really is the new wave coming through, because Messrs. Fiedler and Gane go home with this discipline without a medal of any description at all. And we've got younger riders like Denker, Villanueva and Wolf, new names coming to the fore. It's quite a revelation, this, that those three have taken the medals. I don't think that many people would have put down Dacre, Villanueva and Wolf for the medals in this discipline first thing this morning.
And of course, he'd be the first person to be invited to go to Japan next year for 3 months of racing. So as you see the slow-mo again, he's been sitting on Gane, the Frenchman, for the last two laps. Inside 200 metres, he says, that's it, I'll open it up. And just look here, open up. Remember, he's doing here 40 miles an hour down the home straight, and look at the rest of them. They're just all over the place. They're all just trying to pick up the crumbs, the silver and bronze.
And you mentioned the rest of them, Russ. Where was Jens Fiedler? And the answer is, at the end of the day, Jens Fiedler was nowhere. And he has such a great reputation in this kind of racing. He's used to the hurly-burly of it. He knows all the tactics. But he was nowhere there. Only Laurent Gane of the experienced riders put up any sort of opposition at all. And even he came out without any medal at all. Joby Dacre has really put one over the lot of them.
What a night for the Australians. Two gold medals in the first day.
Well, Jens Fiedler is still all smart.